good afternoon and welcome to News on the Go with me, Darius Jonya. And we are broadcasting to you live here in Oodlands, the residence of Kabwata Member of Parliament, Levy Mkandawire, who has since died after being hit by a moving vehicle just right here where I'm standing outside his premise. So far, as I speak to you, there are quite a number of the party members, that is from the UPND, who have come here to offer their solidarity. And among the people that have come here is the party deputy secretary general, Madam Gertrude Emenda, who is just right here beside me. I will talk to her right at this very moment, just to confirm this particular sad development. Good afternoon, ma'am. You're live on Diamond TV News on the Go.
Good afternoon, Darius.
They need to be protected. Our leaders need to be protected. Yes. That's all I want to say.
All right. Yes. We do know, according to the explanation that you've given us, that she went to the mortuary and also you came here at the scene of the accident. According to the information that you have, would you brief us what you know that had transpired?
What has transpired is that this vehicle was coming from Mr. Mkandawire, Honorable Mkandawire, had parked his vehicle here, and he was going to open the gate. This vehicle from nowhere just came and just hit him and came to hit this fence here, and it is this concrete block here which fell on his head. You can see the blood there.
Maybe we try to move closer.
In the mortuary, I saw his head. He has been hit this side. This is the part. This is that part. You see the blood there. It hit him this side. God knows, maybe the chest and so on. So that's why it was meant that he should not survive. I don't want to believe that it was a mere accident, because what speed was the person? Well, he says the brakes fell. Why coincidentally should the brakes fail when Honorable Mkandawile was opening the gate? No, I don't want to believe that, and I want the police to go to the bottom of this thing. If this policeman still belong to the PF, let them treat that man with kid gloves. But otherwise, no. I appeal to the police command. Let them take this matter very seriously. We are not safe. Our MPs are not safe. Our leaders are not safe.
What you're saying, madam, is that he had parked his car and walked out of the car. He was bashed when he was outside the car.
He was trying to open the gate. And he was bashed outside the gate.
So the vehicle had to rammed into Mkandawile's vehicle, and it moved to Mkandawile and
where Mkandawile was.
Come again, the man here.
He hit the vehicle.
Yes. Yes. He hit the vehicle first at the back, Mr. Mkandawile. Then the same vehicle came now, the assassin's vehicle, I'll call him that, came to hit him here and hit here. And then
that's how the offense
fell. That's how the offense fell.
Thank you very much for.
Where was he coming from?
Okay, all right. That's
the UPND Deputy Secretary General there, Madam Gertrude Emenda, just narrating to us what she has heard as regards to what transpired here. And according to the information that we have received right at this very moment, is that Mr. Mkandawile was just hit there, where I am just pointing at, as he was trying to come out, you know, from his yard. Let me talk to the UPND media director, Tabo Kawana, who has also come here at the residence of Mr. Mkandawile. Good afternoon, sir. You're live on Diamond TV News on the Go.
I wish I could say it's a good afternoon. Clearly, it is not a good afternoon.
We
take the opportunity in this moment of shock and loss for words to pass our sincere condolences to the family of Honorable Mkandawile. We got the news about the accident.
We came here
to see for ourselves.
We've got too many
and
people out there.
What is puzzling?
So
is like you have seen. Firstly, the road itself. This is a speed limit of 30 or 40 kilometers per hour. It is a small street. But if you look at the impact, it shows you that one would not be far from the truth if one suspected that this was an assassination attempt. but we will not speculate. We will leave the matters to the police to be able to investigate, they'll do their job, and when they come up with a conclusion, they'll let us know. But we remain shocked. We remain fearful. We remain lost for words, but at the same time, we remain complaining. Because we cannot understand how a vehicle in this street, which is in a residential area, could be driving at such a high speed and missing all targets, but clearly getting off the road and targeting our member of parliament here to a point where the crash looks like it was intended to ensure that when they hit him, he can't survive the crash. And this is what has happened. So we are shocked. Really, we are shocked. We are saddened by these events. But we leave it all in the hands of the Lord. We also leave the official communication as far as what transpired to the police to do their work. And they will tell us what they would have found on the ground.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Talkawana, for having an interview with us.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Mr. Talkawana there, who is the UPND Alliance Media Director, also giving us an interview as regards to what transpired. According to what, you know, the people, the UPND, you know, members are saying here, they are actually alleging that this could have been an, you know, assassination attempt. But we do understand that the driver who was driving the vehicle has since been arrested, and the police have actually begun investigating this particular, you know, sad development that occurred.
Good evening. This is the Honorable Levy Mkandawire speaking. I'm alive, as you can see from the video. There's a fake news that has circulated on social media. I want to confirm and affirm that Levy Mkandawire is alive, very much alive, as you can see from this video. Thank you very much.
I tell you, he has died. I'm telling you, my husband is just from calling me. Vamwalira bali to my phone manje manje to have Vamukandawile member of parliament.
He was parked there.
Then